namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Today, we are going to study about object and arising of arambana. I think now everyone know how many objects call it arambana. How many objects are there? Six. Arambana and alambana, they are two similar words. Arambana and alambana, both are same. Why it's called arambana? Means there are two words, arambana and alambana. Without any object, cannot arise any consciousness or mental factors. Always the mind depending with object. Chitta and Chetasika delight to something. It's we call arambana. Delight. Alambana. Alambana means hang on. Means like example now we know the some very old people. We also sometimes they cannot work alone. Sometimes they have take some stick. Stick always help for him to walk. Same way, object without object, mind cannot work. This is alambana. Okay. The same way, another example. There some teachers explain that you know the some the blind people, they cannot walk. But we have to make some rope or maybe some stick, the long stick. They always the taking help from them to go and come in. The same way, the alambana. This is object. That's why the Abhidharma explained the without any object cannot appear any consciousness or mental factors. Because mental factors arising all together with depending with the object. Now we are going to study clearly how many objects and which object, how many consciousness can arise with dependent object. Now we know there are mainly five objects. Color object, sound object, smell object, taste object and tangible object. The last one, mental object, dhamma. Now, do you remember the Pattahana? Rupayatanam Chakku Vinyana Dhatuya. Always the color object, the Rupa, always taking the object, eye consciousness. The eye consciousness always taking the color object. Because of color object arising eye consciousness. There are how many eye consciousness?
Two.
Okay. Actually, this color object is only present object. Cannot be in the past, cannot be in the future. For the eye consciousness. Okay. Always must be the present object, present color object to the arise eye consciousness. Okay, sometimes you have seen something before, okay, but you can remind again. At that time, that object become mental object. Same way, saddha itana sota vinyana dhatuya. the sound object support to ear consciousness arise. How many ear consciousness there are?
Two.
Two good and bad. All are resultant, no? The same way, gandha ayatana ghana vinyana dhatuya. Smell object support to arise nose consciousness. There are two nose consciousness. All are in the present object, no? Cannot be in the past, cannot be in the future. For the tongue, rasa ayatana jivha vinyana dhatuya. The taste object for the tongue consciousness. Pottabha ayatana kaya vinyana dhatuya. Tangible object. Patavi, tejo and vayu. Earth element, fire element and wind element. Which we call tangible object support to body consciousness. All are the present object. For the mental object, there are six fold. Object, mental object is six fold. Six fold means there are six type of object inside the mental object, Dhamma, Dhamma Ramana. Okay, now about the mental object, the object of the sixth class cannot be, because the mental object cannot appear the five-door process, cognizance at all throughout, at the same door process. Means the, what are the six? You see the page number two, the last six, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are six kind of objects fall into the categories of mental object, Dhamma Ramana. Sensitive matter, Pasada Rupa. What are the Pasada Rupa? Eye sensitive, ear, nose, tongue and body. Example, some meditators, okay, during the, they want to see clearly what are the materials, what are the sensitive matters they want to know, okay. Now they can remind, they can reflect, they can see the eye, around eye, they are practicing four elements, after that, they can see the eye sensitive, eye base. This is one of the mental object to arise in mind of process, pure mind of process. Always the vision object giving the eye door process. Sound object giving ear door process. Same way, tangible object giving body process. But the mental object cannot produce any of the one of the five. Mental object always producing pure mind door process. Okay. Now, if someone want to see clearly, you are eye sensitive, ear, nose, tongue, body. At that arises only pure mind process. Okay? This is a first meaning. This is a meditation object. Number two, subtle matter, sukuma rupa. Actually, we noted to study the rupa, actually, this one. Then under the sixth chapter, we are under still the fourth chapter. But anyway, if you want to know the object, metal object, the object, we want to know the briefly. Example, about the water element. Okay? Water element, how about their characteristic water element? Flowing and cohesion. Okay, something flowing. But if the water is flowing, but we, if we want to know the characteristic of the water, we cannot see by eye, by ear, by nose, by tongue, by body. We can take only, this is a mental object. But hardness, roughness, cool and heat, same way the pushing, those are we can see by body, in the when taking object from the body door. But the characteristic of the water, we cannot take any of the one of the five, from one of the five. Always we have to take this object, see, by mind. This is a mind process. Same way, the life faculty, one of the matter, the life faculty of whole body. You know the life faculty? Do you have life faculty? How many life faculty? How many life faculty do you have?
One.
Sure? Yeah, there are two. One for the to protect our physical body, one for the protect the mental body. Because one of the mental factor, no? Jivit Indriya, life faculty is one of the mental factor and one of the karma bonds material. Now the example. Now you have the hair, no? Okay, but I don't have hair. But you don't have hair. How about the hair? Do you have any feeling about the life faculty have or not? About hair? Yeah. And the roots of the hair. They have the life faculty. After root, no any life faculty. That's why we can cut. No problem. No any the bleeding or nothing. Anything. Okay? Same with needle in the knee also. The knee. Nail also. If they touch with the flesh, the life faculty. Or come out, no life faculty. Okay? Same way, there's some dry skin. No life faculty. But the skin is still wet, they have life faculty. Okay? Then some meditator want to know about the life faculty. About the saliva. No life faculty. Eh? We pass on the motion. No life faculty. You pass the urinate, but no faculty, life faculty. Okay? This way, if some meditators want to know the life faculty of your body, in the body parts, one by one, this is also very subtle matter. One of the very subtle matter. So, we cannot see by eye, by ear, or we can only by mind. Okay? This is life faculty also one of the subtle object. This is one of the mental object to produce the pure mind process. Same way, you want to know your heart beats. How about your heart beats? You can catch. You can touch by yourself. But actually, according to science, they have the transferring of the heart also. No? But actually, the heart piece is not the heart. Heart is only container. The inside the heart, they have the pure blood. Inside the pure blood, they have the base of the heart. This is the heart base. But we cannot see by eye. Physical eye, but we can see by wisdom eye. This is a heart base become one of the mental object. Okay? Now this way, they have the number 2 is a subtle matter. There are 16 the rupa. There are 16, but we are not included here. Don't even later also you can get the meaning. Only that you want to know only there are 16 rupa. Okay, one more thing. Actually, the first 5 and second 6, they are all are rupa. Why Lord Buddha? Well, anyway, they can put together, no? Why they divide? Why they divide? Because some the eye, ear, nose, tongue, but they are gross. The rupas are gross. All are rupa. Then they are very easy to practice for us. Anicca, Dukkha, Anatta, etc. Okay? But the some subtle matters also can practice Anicca, Dukkha, Anatta. But some subtle rupa cannot practice. Example, space. Space, you know, the Akasa rupa, space matter. Because now the we cannot see any space our body, no? Already covered. But if you want to see slowly, then you can see many hole inside. Many hole. This is space. But the space matter, we cannot practice anicca dukkha anatta. Only just rupa. Knowing the rupa. Okay? But anyway, the some gross rupa and some subtle rupa, all including mind object, the mental object. Number third, all of chitta. Oh. Now, how many chitta? 89 chitta. But some chitta we can reflect by ourselves. Some chitta we cannot reflect. Example, no, sotapatti, magga, pala, etc. We cannot refer it because we don't have any experience. Same way, we cannot, if someone doesn't have any attainment, any jhana attainment, he cannot refer it anymore. He can only image, but image not the not the pure the mind. Okay? This one, 89 qualities become object for us to process, appear the mind process, pure mind process. Especially if someone want to know clearly about the mentality, you want to know clearly. How about this the loba, the greed consciousness, how about the hatred consciousness, etc. Then you can refer it by yourself, and all the time consciousness become object to the mind process. All the 89 consciousness become object for the mind process. Okay? Okay, same way, number 4. 52 mental factors, chetasika. Now, the 52 mental factors become object for us to produce the mental process. The 52 chetasika become mental object. Example now. Now we always talking about the 37 enlightenment factors. Bodhipakya, no? Enlightenment factors. You know? Do you know? What are the enlightenment factors? You should fulfill in your life. If you want to be the enlightenment, if you want to get the enlightenment, if you want to get arahatship, you should cultivate, you should develop 37 enlightenment factors. Those are, according to the ultimate reality, this is chetasika. The example now, the first one, four foundation of mindfulness. Satipatthana. This is actually the mindfulness, the mental factor, the mindfulness of mental factor. The number 2, 4 විලියන සම්මප්පදාන විලිය. බලද? එනර්ජි ෆැක්ටර්. එනර්ජි. Same way, the faculties, energy, and eightfold path, etc., all include only mental factors. So, if someone want to reflect your own faith or on energy, on mindfulness, then all our mental factors become the object for the mind process. Now, the 52 mental factors become mental object. Okay, especially for the the meditators can understand clearly about this the mental object. Number 5 is Nibbana. Okay, who receive Nibbana? Who reach to Nibbana? Then he can refer his own Nibbana. For the Sotapatti, for the Sakadagami, for the Anagami, for the stream enter, one returner, non-returner, arahatship. For the noble person. This is a Nibbana is object for the noble person. Number 6, concept, the panyati. Conventional realities. Means any of the panyati words. Earth, water, the car, vehicle, money, house, world, everything. All are the panyati words. Because panyati object cannot be by, cannot take by eye, ear, nose, tongue, body, all is the mental object. Okay? Now there are 6 objects. Include the mental. Before the 6 kind of object, they are mentioned each of the first 5 objects can be cognized in any of these ways. Means the sometimes the present object can produce 5 door process. And the through the mind door process. What's the meaning? First one, because of the color object, the present color object can appear eye process, okay, eye door process. But we know after 17 mind movement, we cannot understand what is this. This object we cannot see clearly because the first eye door process they can take only color, but they cannot say this is this color, this material, they cannot exactly know. If someone want to know, that's why after 17 mind movement arises following chitta process. But following chitta process also belongs to mind though. But this is not the pure mind though. This is following mind though. But those are mind though also taking the same present object. Same object follow. But sometimes they connect with the past, they have a different action, but anyway, they are following the same object. The same with the number 3rd, that during the last mind process of our life, the dead moment, sometimes the dead moment also can appear eye, ear, nose, tongue, body, one of the five process. But this also taking the present object. Okay, this is a 3. That's why the rebirth, linking, bhavang and death, no? This is process free chitta. Means, what? Now do you know the process free chitta? Do you remember? Bhavanga, patisandhi, chuti, not include any process. Because the process free. Viti mutta. But at that time, some chitta also take the, connected with rupa, sapta, gandha, rasa, potta. But But not for everybody. Example, somebody unconsciousness. They are always their mental object running for them. Someone suddenly accident they passed away. Okay? But they take the person object, the color or sound ear. But anyway, object of the process freed quite deep according to the Abhidhamma. But later, I think here will be explained. There was karma limit. Okay, now briefly. Now you know how many objects? Six. The last one, you know the meaning? The mental object? Okay, there are six kind of object there. Okay? Now we already explained. Okay, now the six kind of object under the mental object, sometimes can be present, sometimes can be past, sometimes can be in the future. But according to the meditation object, quite deep. Example, rupa. Okay? The one rupa, we can see the 11 way. Now the example, now the about the eye sensitive, okay? But we know eye sensory is one of the mental object. But this eye sensitive, we can see 11 type of eye sensitive. In the past, eye sensitive. Present, eye sensitive. Future, eye sensitive. And gross, this is a ghost, eye sensitive. The group, they have some certain rupa. Now, if you want to see the eye sensitive, can see the two way. One say you can see the separately, one another way you can see the with the group. Sometimes you can see the separately eye sensitive, sometimes can see the together with the group. Kalapa. Sometimes you see the kalapa, sometimes individual. Okay? If you want to see with the kalapa, at that time you can see the some gross matter and subtle matter in the kalapa. Okay? Sometimes you are always taking the bad object. Okay? Always can see bad object. At that time, you are the eye sensitive also become like the bad, you know, the no good quality. So, example now, sometimes that you are always seeing the bad object, and then you are some eye pain, no? Eye pain, or maybe mind is not happy. Then, this eye sensor become hina, become the minor quality. Minor. Sometimes, if you can see the good thing every time, good object, then your eye sensor become very bright, very good, this is the superior. Become panita. That's why. But the meditators can practice the different eye sensitive. Then the eye sensor is one of the one rupa, one object, now become 11. Okay? But this is a different way. That's why the object is a very, I cannot say very complicated, but quite deep. But briefly you can understand, you try to get the meaning. But if you want to deeply, quite deep. But without meditation, without practice, the practical knowledge, we cannot understand clearly. Okay? Okay, page number 3 also, I think you already can get the meaning. Everything I already explained. Okay? Because the idle process, how many consciousness arising in the idle process? 46. All now 46 taking the present color object. Okay? Same way in the ear door process, how many consonants are rising? 46. They all are taking the present sound object. Same way, ear, nose, tongue, body. Yeah. Now the mind or chitta, mind of during the mind of process, some mentality material, some in the past, future, present. We can see that clearly. The past object, present, and future. But Nibbana is timeless because Nibbana know any time. Timeless Nibbana. And Panyati also timeless. Okay, Panyati also timeless because they are devoted in it. Yeah, because the Nibbana concept the not include any time. If Nibbana in the past, we cannot see in the present. We cannot see that in the future. But example now the flower, no? The flower, during the Buddha's times, they call the flowers. But we also call them the flowers. In future, also, people call the flower. But different language, different people. But this is the name. Example now, during the Buddha's time, we call the Buddha. Everyone call the Tathagata or Bhagava. But we also now still calling Tathagata and Bhagava. In future also. That's the Nibbana and the Panyati cannot be any time. It is a timeless object. Okay, please come to the table, the page number 7. Okay, now the classification of objects by doors. Eye-door consciousness, object is visible form only, time is present only, okay, cannot be in past and in future. Ear-door consciousness, object is sound, time is present. Nose-door consciousness, object is smell, time is present. Tongue door consciousness, object is taste, time is present. Same way body door. Okay. Now, next one. Object is, the door is overall, but object is 6 types. Time, present, past, future and timeless. Now, karma avachara javana. Now the karma avachara javana meaning the sense sphere, impulsion consciousness javana. How many karma avachara javana? How many sense sphere impulsion consciousness? 29. 12 unwholesome, 8 wholesome, 8 functional and 1 rootless functional. Okay. 12 unwholesome, 8 wholesome, 8 great functional and 1 rootless smile. Okay. But here say x root hatsadu pad. Why? Okay, because hasidu pada only in the past, future, present. The three type of object. But timeless object they cannot get for this mind. Because Lord Buddha never smiled with the Nibbana object. Arahat never smiled with the Nibbana object. Okay? Arahat never smiled with the Panyati concept object. Okay? Anyway, okay. The except Hasitupada 28 Javana. 28 Javana always taking the three time object and timeless object. Did you get the meaning? Example. Okay. One of the loba mind. You are taking present object, color, sound, or etc. One of the present. Same way, yesterday you saw the one flower garden somewhere. Okay, but today you can remind. Oh, I saw these beautiful flowers. No? This is in the past object. But you have to plan. I want to make decorate in my house like this, like this, like this. I want to decorate. This is a future. Okay. Then this is a loba. But Nibbana cannot object for the any akusala. Okay. Nibbana cannot become object for the any akusala. But Panyati concept can be object. Okay. Usually the Nibbana object only for wisdom, kusala and wisdom functional jhana. The some are wholesome arising with wisdom. Some functional arising with wisdom. Nibbana only for object. Okay. Because after the Sotapatti, after the Sotapatti, after reach to the portion knowledge, then they can reflect their path knowledge and portion knowledge and the Nibbana object and the which kind of defilement cut off and what are the remaining defilement. There are five things they can reflect. Then when the Nibbana reflecting moment arising only one of the wisdomful wholesome mind for the Sotapatti. Same way for the Sakadagami, same way for the Anagami. You know the meaning? Sakadagami, Anagami. And for the Arahat, after they receive the portion knowledge, when they are reflecting their Nibbana object, at that arising only wisdomful one of the functional consciousness. Okay? One of the functional consciousness. Okay? Okay, you can get the meaning? Hasitupada. Hasitupada only three times, only in the past, future, and present object. Next one, Abhinya. Abhinya, you know Abhinya? Second power. Okay. But for the Abhinya, one of the three time object or timeless object. Sorry? Timeless. Even the Panyati? Also Nibbana. Because received the Sampasam Arahat, okay? They can check the other's mind. They can see others, he already enlightened or not. His Nibbana also can check. For the Buddha also can check other's mind. No? The Lord will say, he already got Sotapatti, Sakadadami, etc. No? The same way, the timeless object also. Because the example of Dibba Chakku, okay? The divine eye. From the divine eye, who has divine eye, he want to see about the human being around his compound. He want to see the animal being around the compound. This is a panyati, you know? Timeless. Okay? But someone want to see that his own past karma. Example now, after the divine eye, he saw the many ghosts. Peta, huh? Okay, ghost. Then he want to know what is the karma to become the ghost. Then they can see in the past karma, past object. Okay. Then who can see the future. Then you can see the example of the Lord Buddha. Then the one day the our Lord Buddha. When he traveling in the compound, the road with the Bhante Ananda, one of the bird owl. One of the owl birds, they come down and pay respect to Buddha. And then Lord Buddha is mine. Then Bhante Ananda asked, why is my birth? What is the reason? Then Lord Buddha mentioned, Ananda, now this birth or the pay respect. Because of this merit, held to him to until become Pacheka Buddha, silent Buddha. In the future, he become the silent Buddha, his name Somanasa, happiness. But until get, that enlightened, that silent Buddha, he never ever reborn again in the any of woeful place. Now, because of this merit, helped him to become the human and they want to fulfill the parami. Okay, now this is the future. This is the Abhinya, no? Okay? This is also can. Okay, next one. Mahagata Javana. Mahagata Javana means? Sublime consciousness. They are exude second and fourth arupa. Oh, it is very, very detailed. No? Now, how many sublime javana consciousness? There are nine for wholesome, there are nine functional. Yeah, 18. But we take only the nine, only wholesome first. Example, first we have what our world, our mind. If someone want to get the first jhana, which kind of object they have? How many object for the first jhana? Anapana method. Breathing. Okay, anapana method. And kayagata sati. The 32 parts method and yeah, 10 kasina and 10 asubha and metta and karuna and mudita. Okay, those are object. Which object? Color or ear or nose or tongue or body or which kind of object? All are panyati. Concepts. Panyati. all the meditation objects are panyati. All the jhana objects are panyati. Okay? Concept. And cannot be in the past, cannot be in the present, future is all timeless. Timeless. Not include any time. Because why? Everyone can take your own breath. Everyone can practice kasina in the past, future, present, every time. Yes?
So, nimitta is considered a color object. Nimitta. No. So, it's a...
Because the nimitta, we are not going to see by this eye. We are seeing by mind. Because the nimitta appear in front of your nostril or upper lip. Okay? But you are taking object this eye. No. Take it by mind. Nimitta cannot be color object. Okay?
It's produced by a fire, right? Produced by a fire element.
Producing by mind element. The mind mon khalapa. But they have the second generation is the fire element of the mind, the mind mon khalapa. The second, but first generation inside your heart base. Second generation in front of the nostril or upper lip. Okay? This is the meditation. Okay, now, anyway, now you want to know for the first jhana. For the second jhana, how many objects are? Anapana method, but 32 parts cannot produce the second jhana. And the fullness, no? 10 asubhas. 10 asubhas cannot produce second jhana, only first jhana. But 10 kasina can produce second jhana. Metta and karuna mudita also can produce second jhana. Okay? Ola panyati. For the third jhana, how many objects are there? Same. For the fourth jhana, how many objects are there? Same. For the fifth jhana, how many objects are? Except metta, karuna, mudita, but include upekkha. Equanimity. Boundless, no? The upper mind.
Limitless.
Illimitable. Okay? Now, five material jhanas, this is the all object of concept. The important thing, excluding second and fourth arupa, immaterial, because the second and third the immaterial jhana cannot be concept, object cannot be concept. Why? Okay. Now someone want to get the boundless consciousness, boundless jhana, boundless space, akasa nanchayatan, okay? Then first, space kasina, one of the nine kasina he have to use to practice until fifth jhana. After that, he have to reflect the space of his own nimitta. Then he go into the boundless space consciousness. Okay, this is the object concept. But after boundless space consciousness, he reflecting, oh, but my objects become boundless space. But same way my mind also become boundless consciousness. Then he take the object, the mind of the boundless space. Then enter the second jhana, second immaterial jhana. And then the second immaterial jhana, what is the object? citta. The do you have any chant before the draw during the citta notes? Okay. Okay, see? Immaterial sphere of consciousness. This is the object for the infinite, the boundless space. Okay? It's an object. But this consciousness become object to the second. Okay? Space. The first one become object to the second. And same way, first one become object to the third. Still, panyatti for the panyatti object become first, and the first one become object for the third is panyatti. But here, the taking the second one taking the consciousness of the first jhana. The third one they take the conceit. Don't have because of the second jhana, first one disappear. Nothing. Huh? This is nothing. Because this is the concept of object. According to this way, the space one of the object for the first jhana, first jhana's consciousness object for the second jhana, and the because of the second jhana, first jhana disappear. Because of disappear, object become third jhana, the third jhana's consciousness become object for the fourth jhana. Now this way, the second and fourth arising because of the consciousness, because of citta. And then, you see that, second and fourth arupa jhana, object is citta. And past, already, before, cannot be the present, cannot be in the future. Okay? Okay, again. Now this space means the one of the eight kasina. The fifth jhana of the eight kasina. Or nine kasina. Example, someone practicing the red kasina. Up to fifth jhana. Okay? Then after fifth jhana, he think, I want to enter the infinite space means the boundless space conscious. I want to enter the immaterial jhana. Then he take space of the fifth jhana. Then space become object for the first immaterial jhana. Okay, what is the object of the immaterial jhana? What is the object? Space of fifth jhana. This means concept of mind. Panyatti, no? Panyatti. The panyatti object. They are taking the panyatti object. After first jhana, the meditator, he want to enter the second immaterial jhana. At that time, he is taking object. What is his object? Consciousness that has infinite space as object. Okay, now hitting only the space, boundless only space, because this space produced by mind. Then he take the mind of the consciousness of the first jhana become object of the second jhana. The second jhana is taking object, the mind. This is already past. The mind is object but this object is in the past. Atita. Past object. Okay? After that, third one, now he also needs the object. He cannot take consciousness of the second jhana. But his meaning, because of the second, first one disappeared. Nothing. You see? The absence of the consciousness that has infinite space as object. Okay? Absent. Nothing. Don't have. Disappear. Now this disappear. become the object of the jhana. The disappear or absence is a panyati, not the mind. Tajana. Then the fourth one, the third one is that consciousness is quite so calm, peaceful. That is the object, consciousness of the third jhana. And to the arise for the fourth one. Then what's the object? You see? Consciousness as an object, knowing it as a superior, as peaceful. Now, number second and fourth jhana become what's the object? Chitta. Chitta become object for the second and third jhana. And in the past object, cannot be in the present, future, timeless. Okay? The supermundane jhana, only object is Nibbana and timeless. Understand, no? Okay. So, next part. For the title, six type as a karma, karma nimitta and gati nimitta. The present, past and timeless. Karma nimitta and gati nimitta. In the past, present or timeless. Okay.
Futures are here.
Yeah, but for the gati nimitta. Okay. In a bit more, we can see in the future what they're going to be doing. The Deva world. Okay, this also we'll consider panyati. Okay. Now we are going to talk about the birth linking moment. The birth object of the birth linking moment. And now, do you remember? We already studied before for the sensual plane and Brahma plane and immaterial plane. There are three planes, the three worlds. Okay, but there are different object, different birth linking consciousness. All are not same. First, we are going to talk karma vachana patisandhi, the birth linking of sense sphere plane. Okay? There are five sense objects in six doors as sign of karma nimitta. Karma nimitta, past and present. Okay. Now, what is the meaning karma? What is the meaning of karma nimitta? What is the meaning of gati nimitta? The three words. One of the three appearing near death moment. One of the three. What is the meaning of karma? Karma is action, volition. Okay? Example now. If someone near death moment can see the what he had done before, the good thing, but he cannot see the material. He can refer to the mind only. Example now, in the past life. Okay, I already done many good things, but any of the one of the powerful good thing rose of the nearly dead moment, appeared in the nearly dead moment. And then I offer the one flower basket for the Buddha. I already offer one flower basket. But if I, near the dead moment, if I can see the flower basket or pagoda or Buddha image or anything, it's called sign of karma. Okay, this is a karma nimitta. Sometimes I cannot see the flower basket, I cannot see the Buddha image, pagoda or etc. I cannot see any people, but I can refer to the mind, the consciousness of this offering. This is we call karma. Okay? Karma. There are only two meanings. Understand?
Yes.
Third one, but near the dead moment, I cannot see. This is the same power of the flower basket, offering of flower basket. But I cannot see the flowers or image anything in the past, and I cannot see them by my wholesome mind also. But power of this karma, I can see where I am going to reward. Maybe because now I am already in the human world, no? Maybe I can see the mother's womb. If I can see the near little mother's womb, okay, definitely I am going to the human world. This is we call the gati nimitta, the sign of the destiny, our destination place. Okay, the someone near the dead moment, they can see the deva. Okay, one of the donor during the Buddha's time, his name Dhammika. You know that his history, Dhammika Upasaka. He always done the good thing for the sasana. Near the dead moment, his children invited to the sangha to come his house for the chant, paritta, for the blessing for his father. Oh, Buddha's time was there, no? Near the dead moment, they invite the monk for recite paritta. Okay, this is a traditional, it's start from the Buddha's time, not this moment. Okay? Then at that time, the bhikkhu, when they recite in the paritta, that upasaka, he holding his hand, stop, but he not take anything, but he just only action. That all the bhikkhu thought, oh, he don't want to listen paritta. They stop. After they report to the, they were after the, when monastery, report to Buddha. Okay? Then all our children, they're not happy. They say, oh, my father may be now crazy or something, have a mind, that's why he don't want to receive, maybe. No, they're worried about that. After that, the children ask the father, why you stop the chanting? No, I know not my mind to stop paritta. I stop the deva. Many deva with vehicle, they around, they came to here to bring me. I told this, wait, until finish the, I won't listen the paritta. After that, you can bring me. This is a gati nimitta. Do you want to get like this nimitta needed at moment? You have to practice dhamma diligently. Yeah. Without practice dhamma, you cannot get like this destination. No?
See the forest.
Yeah.
Is it a
ghost?
Pita.
No, but I cannot say some animals. Mm. Animals. Or, because animal always in the forest, no? Okay, but if they have the forest is very nice. Cannot be dark. If someone can see the forest, if they are very dark or very dangerous, this is not for the good life. But some forest can see very calm, very peaceful, and the bloom in the flowers is main. But this is a good place. Yes. Okay? Now you know the meaning of kamma and kamma nimitta gati nimitta. Okay? Then, but three objects cannot appear the same moment. One of the three come in immediate moment. Okay? Some like karma or karma nimitta gati nimitta. That's why some meditators, if they want to check the object of the birth linking moment, then they are going to the past life. When they are checking, so many objects coming. So many objects. Then one of the object become the object become the birth linking moment. Cannot be all. But anyway, one day you can get the experience after practice meditation. Okay, now, according to the here, five sense object in the sixth door as a sign of karma, karma nimitta, in the past or present. You understand? Because karma nimitta can appear by eye door or ear door, nose door, tongue door, body door, mind door. And sometimes it can take in the past object or present object. Okay? And the mental object is mind door as karma or sign of the karma. But this is the past object. Sometimes for who is unconsciousness, he don't know to take any object by five door, but he take only mind door. At the time, sometimes the karma and sometimes the karma nimitta. You can image your, okay, example now, you already offer very big dana, maybe when you was young, but now you are a very old age now, near that moment. You can image what we had done in before. You can image all, like the movie. One by one, you can see the image. This is the mind door, this is the past. And the visible form in the mind door as a sign of this is the present object. Okay, this present object, no? Okay. Now, sometimes the color object coming from the mind door about the future, your place of your destiny, the sign of the destiny. This is a present object. Yeah. And the rupa avachara patisandhi. Rupa avachara. Rupa avachara patisandhi means your fine material, birth, linking, moment. The concepts, mental object as sign of karma. Now see? Karma nimitta, timeless. Same way, first and third, immaterial, sphere, birth linking consciousness. Also, karma nimitta, timeless. Second and fourth, immaterial, sphere, birth linking consciousness. This is a karma nimitta, this is a chitta. Chitta means karma nimitta, past object. Okay? Rest or maybe you can. If I push too much, don't you think? Because. You know, they are stable, they are listening, but if I was too much, we should do. Yeah. Okay, then, good enough for about the object now. Because but we have the another chapter the, under the object, that each mind can have which, how many object. Example now, we know icons only take only one object. But same way, example now, the five to adverting consciousness. How many objects? There are five. Color, sound, etc. There are five. But in the one by one, they explain. But I think you also can understand. But they have the notes. The page number 11. Okay? Okay, now I want to explain the briefly about the Vaktu. Analyzing of bases. This is also very easy, but the important thing about the planes. Because in our human world, we have all our faculties, eye, ear, nose, tongue, body and heart base. Because now this is the mind dome is heart base. Eye base for the eye dome. Ear base for the ear door, nose base for the nose door, tongue base for the tongue door, body base for the body door, heart base for the mind door. So only different. Heart base for the mind door. Now, one thing. Okay, please take the chart. the first chart, the now the sense sphere, fine material, immaterial. Okay? Kamavachara, Rupavachara and Arupavachara. But I have in the karma world, in the sense sphere or and fine material world. But don't have any immaterial world. Same way here, also in the find the immaterial, the sense sphere material world and sorry, sense sphere world and fine material world. Here. But don't have any thing in the immaterial world. But only ear and sorry, eye and ear we can see in the Brahma world. Only Brahmas have only eye and ear. Okay? The fine materials Brahma. But only eye and ear. But don't have nose, don't have tongue, don't have body. Don't have nose meaning? They cannot practice anapana method. Don't have wind, don't have breath. Okay? They cannot practice anapana method after going Brahma world. Huh? Someone say, okay, after the Brahma world, I can practice anapana method. Cannot practice anyway. And but the taste, don't have food, good food there, okay? In the Brahma world, don't have nutrition food. Huh?
So in the Brahma world, they cannot attain
jhana. They can attain jhana.
Without anapana.
Yeah, but other option? Because
yes.
The khasina or maybe other option. Okay? We can only practice anapana. Even they cannot practice 32 parts. Because they don't have 32 parts. They cannot practice asubha, the fallenness method. Don't have dead body. They can produce only khasina. Okay? And metta and karuna mudita. Upekta. But some Brahma, they are not present in the lower jhana. If someone is in the second Brahma level, they don't want to produce the lower one, but they want to produce the highest one. This is the nature of the Brahma world. Okay, so who is staying in the second, third level? They don't want to practice the lower jhana. They want to practice the highest jhana. Okay? And the body don't have male and female faculty. And but they have the body just look like the man, but don't have the body base also. In the Brahma world. Okay? About the heart. Heart base have in the Brahma world. Actually, for the eye and ear, only for seeing Buddha and listening Dhamma. Because the very sometimes they can appear in the Brahma world. Sometimes appear the lobha mind in the mind too. Lobha consciousness arises in the mind too. Because they are attached to the jhana. Attached to jhana. Because of the but they never appear any lust mind after seeing any color or any sound. Difficult. Because their eye for only for see the Buddha and for the great Arahat Gauri. For the ear only for listening down. They are not taking the other sound object. Okay? And the immaterial world don't have any base. No eye, no ear, no nose, no tongue, no body, no heart. Very good, no? Very good. Yes. Cannot practice. Nobody, how they give nobody, how they get relaxed. Only the mentality, only mental, only the mind and the mental factors.
Huh?
The one day it disappears. Yes, only
come to the world.
Yeah.
Come to the world and so regret.
when they come to the Brahma world or human world, we can have the body at the moment.
They will regret a lot.
Huh?
Regret. So why going to why
oh, going? Because they because the attachment of the boundless dhyana.
Oh.
Now someone say, oh, always operate this body. I don't want the body. Sometimes you also fight with your body, no?
Yeah.
Sure or not?
Yes.
Yeah, fighting. Oh, because of the body make the problem for us. Difficult to practice level because of this body. I don't want to get. I don't want. Then someone, after reach the fifth turn of the fine material, they say, oh, I don't want this body. I don't want. Then that's why they are going to practice the arupa jhana. Huh? Is the mind is the calm, then mind is peaceful, then the physical body. I don't know this matter. Because of this attachment, they will reborn in the arupa world. But one good thing, someone practicing the samatha vipassana both in the human world, and they reach to the sotapatti. They already got the sotapatti. After that, they practicing the immaterial dhyana. Then they are going to that world. And they can practice other person, they can enter the other Margapala in Arahaship. They never come back again. If someone want to go there, better go with the at least Sotapatti. Then save your life. Otherwise, during the Sasana moment, it is no good place for us. Because that place, the waste of our time. Because you know how long? 20,000 kap maha kappa, the first boundless world and the boundless space world. The 40,000 second and 60,000, 84,000. Maha
kappa.
Yeah, no form, only the mind and the mental factors. No, we cannot see by our eyes. Cannot see anything. Okay.
So, to avoid wasting time, can we don't practice immaterial?
No. But if some, we can practice the immaterial jhana, but you don't attach. I want to get this object near that moment. I want to go this world. This is a danger. But we should practice during the sasana. Otherwise, you cannot get the abhinya. Who has wished to get the abhinya? You should practice the immaterial jhana. Okay.
So,
and someone want to practice the vipassana. Then that also we have to practice vipassana under the some the immaterial jhana also. We have to practice vipassana.
So Bhante, what type of mental factor they possess? Is it wisdom?
Yeah.
You say they possess mental factor. They have mental factor.
Yeah, my consciousness and mental factors there. Because they are birth linking moment.
Yeah.
Birth linking. Then now the how many mental factors in the boundless space consciousness? How many?
What? It's not 1 or 52, right?
No. But in the birth linking moment, maybe 31, including consciousness, 31 mental factors in the birth linking moment. Same way in the life continuing moment also 31, in the death moment also 31. But for the boundless space world, who reborn they are, sometimes can appear only the greedy mind to attach their world, attach to his existence
plane.
This is the lower mind can arise. Cannot appear dosa because no any form, no people to see, no sound. Okay, and the same way some can appear the upekkha wholesome mind, cannot happiness wholesome also. Loba also cannot happiness loba. All the equanimity. This is all the equanimity world.
Wisdom.
Wisdom, they have wisdom because the bird linking world, they have wisdom. Okay. Okay, but anyway, there are the many details in the notes, but no time to explain all. But now you know the brief meaning of the six bases. And but anyway, now you know the how to analyze the feeling and roots and the functions and those and objects and bases. There are six. Now the, according to this lesson, there are six types of classification. Okay. There are six types of classification, but you have to read again and again. You have to check reference of other books, and you have tried to discuss with your friend and discuss with other teachers also to develop your Dhamma knowledge. And don't stop, and it's continuously practice meditation. To understand all things. Without practical knowledge, without meditation, we cannot understand all. Okay? But briefly we can get the meaning after reading the book, after listening to Dhamma. But if you want to get the deeply and the detail, you should practice meditation. Okay?
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Nibbanasya
Accayo
Accayo